silence your cell phones and other noise-making devices and refrain from texting. Take a moment to identify the nearest available exit should you need one in the unlikely event of an emergency. We should take a moment to acknowledge the land on which we are gathered. For thousands of years, this land has been the home of Putwin people. Today, there are three federally recognized Putwin tribes: Cacheldeehee Band of Wintun Indians of the Colusa Indian Community, Quetzaldeehee Wintun Nation, and Yochadeehee Wintun Nation. The Putwin people have remained committed to the stewardship of this land over many centuries. It has been cherished and protected as elders have instructed the young through generations. We are honored and grateful to be here today on your traditional lands. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Reimaginings. Our concert tonight celebrates choral music that reinterprets the genre through stylistic fusion and juxtaposition, rearrangement, and through the revival of historical works by composers who have been excluded from the Western classical canon. Tonight's concert showcases all three of our UC Davis choirs performing music from the medieval period through modern day. You'll hear solo chansons translated for treble, chorus, and harp, pieces that meld traditional Hindustani vocal techniques and indigenous melodies with the Western choral tradition, and masterworks by Isabella Leonardo and Jose Mauricio Nunez Garcia, among other repertoire. A bit of info about each of our pieces, as well as the composers featured tonight, can be found in your program, along with texts and translations, and I invite you to follow along as we go through the concert. Once more, welcome, thank you for being here, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us this evening. The last piece on tonight's program is a premiere of sorts, despite it being several hundred years old at this point. José Mauricio Núñez García was a bit of a superstar, a very important figure in his time in 18th century Brazil. He was a prolific composer, conductor, keyboardist, church musician, and he's often credited as one of the first and foremost proponents of classicism in the Americas. Despite all this, his music has largely been omitted from our narratives of music history for racial and geographic reasons. Tonight, we celebrate his brilliance with a performance of Laudate Dominum, that is, as far as I could research, the first performance of this work in California, and possibly a West Coast first as well. This work has been such a joy to bring to life this quarter, and we are so excited to finally share it with you tonight. Once again, thank you for being here, and I hope to say hi to all of you out in the lobby after the concert. Enjoy.